So as our revision topic of cell biology, that is cell division, continues, yesterday we have done about the G1 phase, and let's start with the G0 phase. This G1 phase is a growth one phase, and this growth one phase includes the formation and increase in the cell size, formation of cell organelles, mitochondria, plastids, different lysosomes, then we have the formation of endoplasmic reticulum, then we have the Golgi bodies also, the protein, RNA and histone proteins are being formed. This is the G1 phase, is the longest phase. Before entering into the S phase, there is a checkpoint, and that checkpoint can be long enough that the cell will die in that condition, or if needed, that can go into the S phase, synthesis phase, getting ready for next cell division. This G0 phase is also known as quiescent stage. The G0 is known as quiescent stage, and this quiescent stage directly depends upon contact inhibition. Now, what is contact inhibition? Whenever a cell is touched from other cells from all of the sides, in that condition, the cell signaling pathways make sure that the cell which is present or itself does not perform the function of cell division. And if the cell from G1 phase enters into the S phase, then the S phase will surely complete. The checkpoint which is present in G1 phase are the checkpoints that can maintain the cell into inactive stage, only metabolically active. If a cell enters in S phase, then there is the cell is committed to complete the DNA duplication or replication, that is doubling up of the chromatin material. This contact inhibition is maintained by some of the chromosomes and gene which are present, and this contact inhibition is very much responsible for. So particularly we are talking about G0 phase, the significance of G0 phase. What are the significance of G0 phase? Very first, limited growth. Limited growth means the cell will surely stay in the differentiated form, and that is non-divisible form. It is only metabolically active. So no extra nutrient required, no extra energy production required. The maintenance of the body, the multicellular body, will be easier. So that is infinite growth, finite growth, that is limited growth. Second we have is less energy required. See, continuously, if a cell is continuously dividing, it will surely be needing the ATP. Now ATP is needed for protein production, RNA production, DNA production, cell division, spindle fiber production and centriole duplication. So that will also save the energy for the cell to perform other functions which are not related to the cell division, that is production of some proteins which are very much responsible for normal physiology. Third thing we have is
परफॉर्मिंग स्पेशल फंक्शंस,
व्हिच मींस दैट इफ अ सेल इज इन जी नॉट फेज इट कैन परफॉर्म सर्टेन फंक्शंस व्हिच आर कंटिन्यूअसली डिवाइडिंग सेल्स कैन नॉट परफॉर्म. दैट इज द इम्यूनोलॉजिकल सेल्स कैन प्रोड्यूस द एंटीबॉडीज, द टी लिम्फोसाइट कैन गिव सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी, बट द सेल विच इज कॉन्टिन्यूअसली डिवाइडिंग कैन नॉट डू एनी ऑफ दिस.
Then we have a cell after division completes the G1 phase, enters into G0 phase, and then there is the division of labor, or we can say differentiation, which means the cell will not divide but assigned with a particular function to perform. So these are main topic points. The G0 phase is responsible for mainly in human body all of the cells are present in G0 phase, and this maintains the definite growth. Then we have the S phase. And the S phase is synthesis phase. Now this synthesis phase is directly related to the DNA, RNA and protein formation. What will happen? DNA, which is present in amount 1, that will replicate. And that DNA replication, now the DNA goes into 2x. 2x means now the structure of the chromosome of a cell in G1 phase is like this. Is like this. But after replication, the chromosome structure become like this. So this means 1 DNA and this means 2 DNA. Okay? Number is chromosome. This is one chromosome. This is also one chromosome. But amount of DNA is, if it is 1, then it is 2. This is double DNA amount. Along with this doubling of DNA, something more happens, and that something more is production of RNA. And proteins. Now RNA is for the production of these proteins only, but these proteins are, what type of these proteins are? Histones, which are being produced for making a DNA from making a chromosome from this structure of a DNA into this supercoiled form of DNA. Histone proteins are of 5 types: H1, H2A, H2B, H3 and H4. These are 5 type of DNA. From these 5, these four, the H1, H2A, H2B, H3 and H4 are octameric. And this H1 is the linker protein. Okay, so this H1 is linker protein and these four are octameric proteins, which will make the octamer. Remember, I have told you in the previous video that an octamer will be formed and one in the center. This octamer is responsible for coiling the DNA around it.
Okay, the octamer is responsible for coiling the DNA around it.
The DNA is about 200 to 250 base pairs. Now, this much of the DNA is just coiled on this octameric end. Now, what is the role of the H1 protein? This H1 protein will bind the DNA.
Okay, this H1 protein will bind the DNA. These are the octameric protein, and this H1 is the linker protein. Okay, that prevent the DNA from loosening up. So these things are happening in S phase. Apart from these, what type of more proteins are being produced? Proteins that are responsible for formation of spindle fiber. Which proteins are responsible for making spindle fiber? These are actin proteins. Okay, so in G2 phase, when the G2 phase is about to complete, what happens? The cell starts to assemble the spindle fiber. Now spindle fiber if starts to assemble in G2 phase, वो अगर G2 phase में assemble होना शुरू होते हैं, तो हमें किसी भी cell को वो spindle fiber proteins पहले से तैयार करके रखने पड़ते हैं. Then some more proteins are being formed, and these proteins are, now I am talking about whole S phase, not early S phase, mid S phase or late S phase. That I am talking about is complete S phase, but more type of proteins are being formed, and these proteins are replication machinery. The replication machinery includes, now see, everything in our body is completed with the help of proteins only, right? From digestion to transport of oxygen to carbon dioxide, which is we exhale. Also, the neurological processes, the formation of something. Now, these proteins are everywhere in your body, and proteins are enzyme only. Okay, so everything is dependent directly upon the protein. Okay. And the enzymes that are being formed, which enzymes are used? We have DNA. Now I'm gonna make a structure, and that structure is particularly the chromatin, which is present in the nucleus. Now I'm not gonna make the double helical model, but a single helical model. What are these? The structure which I have made is this. The name given to the structure is nucleosome. Okay, the name given is nucleosome. So these nucleosomes and this is chromatin present in the body, in the cell, this must be replicated. Okay, so taking into account this structure, or we can say this structure, now the DNA which is coiled around this octamer must be opened. Clear with this? This DNA cannot replicate while being coiled on this octamer, so इसे भी हमें खोलना पड़ेगा. and that kholna is also with the help of enzyme. Now the DNA structure is like this, which means it is coiled. Now coiling is like this. Okay, so this coiling must be eased out. Ise hame seedha karna padta hai. And that also cannot happen without enzymes. So from this structure to this structure, enzyme is needed. Then we have something else. Remember, we are talking about the replication machinery, and the replication machinery is being formed in this S phase along with the DNA replication, along with the histone proteins and certain other proteins which are spindle fibers. So now this must be opened like this. Okay, this must be opened like this. If no protein is being formed in the S phase, DNA replication kabhi ho hi nahi payega. Theek hai? To अब आपने कभी एक्सपेरिमेंट अगर अब अगर किसी एक कोइल्ड रस्सी को आपने खोलने की कोशिश की है, देन यू जस्ट होल्ड द टू थ्रेड्स विच आर कोइल्ड अराउंड विच इज अ रोप. आप अगर उसे खोलने लगते हैं, देन रस्सी में आगे की तरफ जो भी कोइल्स प्रेजेंट है, जो भी घुमाव प्रेजेंट है, उसमें टाइटनेस आनी शुरू हो जाती है. ठीक है? तो अगर इस डीएनए को यहां से पकड़ के खोलना शुरू किया जाए, या इस डीएनए को यहां से पकड़ के खोलना शुरू किया जाए, सी आई एम मेकिंग अ स्ट्रक्चर लाइक दिस. अगर मैं इसे खोलना शुरू करता हूं तो इन कॉइल्स में क्या है, टाइटनेस आनी शुरू हो जाएगी, एंड दैट टाइटनेस मस्ट बी रिमूव्ड. तो दैट इज ऑल्सो टू बी रिमूव्ड. नाउ talking about the enzymes, from this to this, the enzyme known as gyrase, from this to this, the enzyme known as helicase, from this to making the DNA normal again, wo tightness jo hai use remove karna is with the help of enzyme टोपो आइसोमेरेज. एंड दीज आर ओनली फ्यू एंजाइम्स दैट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट. तो आई वॉज जस्ट गिविंग यू एन एग्जाम्पल विच एंजाइम्स आर बींग फॉर्म. नाउ रेप्लीकेशन इज अ कप ऑफ टी फॉर अनदर डे. वी विल जस्ट सी, और द पर्सन हु इज रीडिंग फॉर बोर्ड्स, we will be meeting in class 12, and then you will see the replication, transcription and translation, which is central dogma. So coming back from S phase, now if the cell have completed the G1 phase and entered into the S phase, there is a sure shot possibility, there is a sure shot thing that a cell will must cell will complete the S phase. There is no checkpoint other than DNA damage. So if DNA becomes damaged, if there is a mistake during the proof reading, ek bar DNA ko ek DNA se do DNA banane ke baad mein uski proof reading ki jati hai ke jo pehle DNA tha, kya ye dusra DNA bilkul exactly uske same bana hai ya nahi. तो उस प्रूफ रीडिंग के लिए भी एंजाइम्स होते हैं. तो अगर प्रूफ रीडिंग में कहीं प्रॉब्लम आ जाती है, देन ओनली द एस फेज विल बी अरेस्टेड, नहीं तो एस फेज विल कंटिन्यू टिल द लास्ट. कमिंग बैक ऑन टू दिस क्वेसेंट स्टेज, नाउ मे आई रब दिस. कमिंग बैक ऑन टू दिस क्वेसेंट स्टेज,
a cell which is in contact inhibition with the other cells. The cell which is in contact inhibition with the other cells this contact inhibition is maintained by some genes, okay, and if these genes get damaged or these genes gets mutated, then the contact inhibition property of these cells will become negligible. They will lose the contact inhibition activity, or you can say the process, and this central cell will continues to grow infinitely. मतलब ऐसा एक ग्रोथ, ऐसी एक सेल डिवीजन जिसका कोई अंत नहीं है, जिसमें जी नॉट फेज कभी भी नहीं आता, द सेल इज नोन एज इफ एनी ऑफ द चेक पॉइंट प्रेजेंट बिटवीन द जी वन एंड जी नॉट फेज इज फेल्ड एट दैट पॉइंट सेल बिकम्स कैंसरस. ओके, द सेल बिकम्स कैंसरस. सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर टूडे. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर दिस वीडियो. मेक श्योर टू लाइक, सब्सक्राइब एंड गिव इट अ थम्स अप. दैट मीन्स अ लॉट टू मी. हमने आज बात करी जी नोट फेज और एस फेज के बारे में. टुमारो वी आर गोना स्टार्ट विद, और इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी आर गोना स्टार्ट विद जी टू फेज, एंड ऑल्सो वी विल सी सम प्राइमरी प्रिपरेशंस दैट अ सेल डू बिफोर माइटोसिस और मियोसिस, एंड देन वी विल कंटिन्यू विद माइटोसिस एंड मियोसिस इन सेपरेट वीडियोस. सो थैंक यू सो मच. मेक श्योर टू गिव इट अ थम्स अप.